This time we're working on McKinney, Texas. On this house, we're going to be installing hybrid piers. So this house had a previous foundation repair done with concrete piers.
So we're going to be installing 32 hybrid piers to fix the foundation. The old concrete piers failed, and now with the hybrid piers, we're gonna make sure that this won't happen again. The soil beneath this foundation is expansive clay soil, which is very prone to failure. The piers are going about 25 feet deep. We're installing 20 feet with a steel pipe, and then we're transitioning to the last 5 feet with cylinders. We also need to do some interior piers, but to minimize the destruction inside the house, we're going to be doing some tunneling. This is a big house with a huge foundation. On the right, we have the old concrete piers, and on the left, we have our hybrid pier. We have about 6 piers installed out of 32. There you can see the expansion joint that is wide open. The foundation is about 2 inches low. The exterior grade beams of the foundation are approximately 3 feet deep. As you can observe here, this is a big house, and the concrete footings are around 3 feet deep. Most of the piers are exterior, but about 8 of them have to be installed under the house. We're going to dig about 4 holes inside the house and 2 tunnels to reach some of the locations to avoid destroying the floors. There you can see some more damage on the stone caused by the foundation settling. So today is our 5th day of foundation repair here on this house in McKinney, Texas. We have installed almost all of the piers. We were supposed to do 36 piers, but this house had the grade beams about 6 to 5 feet apart from each other. Right there in the house, we're going to be installing about 8 additional piers. And of course, this is going to be at no extra cost to the homeowner.
So all of the exterior work is ready and the exterior piers are already installed. And now we're just working inside the house and I'm going to show you.
So what we did is we're only digging here on the entrance of the house. The customer didn't care about this tile, but they do care about the hardwood flooring on all the inside. So we're digging a tunnel from here to get all the way under the fireplace. Then we have a grade beam that goes, this footing goes like this, all the way to the back. And then we also have another footing that cross here. So this footing, we're gonna reach beneath the fireplace through that. That hole is gonna have a pier installed under the footing there. Then we have another pier under the footing there. And then on the outside, we do a tunnel that comes all the way to the center of the dining room.
Okay guys, so we finished digging the tunnels and installing the piers. I'm gonna show you inside the tunnel here beneath the house. We have all the piers installed right here. So we're just setting up the top caps and then the bottle jack so we can lift. You can see the concrete foundation is unusual. It's good because this is stronger than the average foundation. The black thing is the moisture barrier. And you can see here. So yeah, this is gonna be kind of challenging to lift because it's going to be super heavy, but we have the piers spaced at about 4 feet apart from each other and we're supporting and securing all of the footings of the house. So yeah, we're gonna have fun lifting this.
So we're installing like 42 piers and each pier went about 25 feet deep with a steel pipe. So approximately 1,000 pipes and another like 14 cylinders per hole. So in cylinders we have used like 550. We're gonna need about another 150 for the shimming plus about 1,000 pipes. So yeah, this is quite a big job. It's taking a lot of material, but it doesn't matter because we need to make sure that we go as deep as we can.
So take a look at how messy this is. And I'm not showing you all this mess to scare you. It's more so you can see how when we finish, it all looks like we were never here.
Hey guys, so this is our last day of foundation repair on this house and we're just gonna start lifting right now. The house needs to be lifted about 2 inches, but we might only lift it about an inch and a half. Okay guys, we just finished leveling the house. Here you can watch how much we lift. We lift about 2 inches. The house still has like half inch low. It was like 2.5 to 3 inches low. We lifted about two inches. So we have difference now of half inch to 3/4 inch. So you can see the big gap in here. The concrete was sitting here. Now my hand can go in. So same here. You can see we have a lot of piers and a lot of bottle jacks. That's why we were able to lift. The house was super heavy. All of our bottle jacks are 32 tons jacks. And let's go inside the tunnel. Weather is really hot today. So here you can watch all the lift. Those gaps are how much, like those gaps show how much we lift. Here, you can see all the bottle jacks. And here. So this is the tunnel that we have on the outside and I'll show you the other tunnel on the inside. But yeah, you can see here all this gap. Like I said, this is how much we lifted. So it was kind of challenging. Again, the house has a lot of footings. The footings are huge. As you can see, we have like 4 feet of concrete. And yeah, so the good thing is we install piers at every 5 to 6 feet apart from each other. We located all of the grade beams and that's how we were able to lift all this. So now after lifting, the guys are going to start shimming the piers and removing the bottle jacks. We had an issue with the plumbing here. It's kind of common because, you know, like the pipe for that faucet goes into the concrete slab. So when we lift, the pipe probably cracked. So we're gonna have to dig and make sure like we can fix it so we can cover up everything. So it's been, today is the sixth day of hard work, but we're finally done. And so I'm gonna show you the expansion joint that was open like an inch and a half. You can compare the difference here. I took a video of this expansion joint the first day when we arrived. It was open, so this pretty much closed because of the lift. So originally it was planned to install like 34, 36 piers. The house had a lot of concrete beams very close to each other. So we ended up installing like 44 piers. Like I said, we don't charge additional for that. It's just an unforeseen surprise. But the goal is to make sure the house lifts properly and we secure it. Without supporting all those beams, the house will probably settle down in the future again. And we need to make sure that this doesn't happen again, because as you can see, it's very messy. So we don't want to go through the same process another time. So here, the fireplace is right there where Julio's working. And here, again, you can see the gap around the entire house where we'll lift. Here is very obvious. So this is how much the house lift. Again, the concrete was sitting on the soil, and with the lift, this is how much it went up. It's a very common question to ask if the void will be a problem down the road, but no, it doesn't matter that we have that void because the entire house is now sitting on the piers. I have explained this many times, but for all the new viewers, when the house goes up, because we have it supported with the piers at every 6 feet distance, like for example, you can see here, that's like an intersection of two beams and we have two piers. Same here, it's like a crossing. So we have the two piers on each side of the cross. And again, we have more piers over there, and we have another pier right here, another pier right there. So because of that, it's like those bridges on the highway. You see they're floating. Well, they're not floating. The weight of the bridges is sitting and being distributed to the bedrock thanks to the piers, to the columns. So same with the house. Even that we can see some void, is not gonna be a problem because all the footings and all the weight of the house is sitting on the piers at every 6 feet apart from each other. And that way, the weight of the house is being redirected into the bedrocks through the piers. So here, Carmelo already finished shimming that pier, and the next step is gonna be start backfilling the holes. So all of the holes where we found two beams, you can see that we do the same. We have the cross like this and this, you know, like the beam goes from the front across all the way to the back, and then we have another beam that goes like that. So we have the piers right beneath the beams so we can support the house for the years to come. After removing all the bottle jacks and finishing shimming the piers, now we're just backfilling everything. After backfilling, we're gonna start cleaning up the entire job site and make sure that it looks like we were never here. And we're just finishing the repair, so let's walk around the job site and take a look at how it looks.